So the challenge, if it either will be released now after this call or it's already released. So just maybe Everest or Arun.
We'll release the challenge just after this call.
Okay. So the challenge will be released. And I think the kind of the formats is going to be almost identical, except just the number of submissions are reduced. So it will be only, if it's a week challenge, it will be only twice. One, the interim report on Wednesday, and then the other one on Saturday, just the final submissions. And the tutorials will be also reduced to 3. So you will have a lot more time to actually explore and interact. And therefore, it's going to be a lot more of you asking, interacting, and also whenever there is a need, because the tutors will be slightly much more expecting to provide challenge on need spaces. Like when there is a certain form of, you know, challenge from everyone, we can organize sessions that would address that particular issue. So it would be a much more only, a lot more of, it is a need spaces and much more of community and, you know, self-learn that will be required. And also we will announce, I think we have finished at least just a very preliminary version of 10X that you will be able to now log in. So we will send also that one. It's gonna be on 10x.10academy.org. You will have, so your password, the first time you log in, it will be just your email, the one you used for Google Class. So the email and password will be identical, but then you will be asked to change the password in your first login. And from that on, so at the moment, the most important element that is there is that, of course, you will be able to go directly from there to Google Classroom as well as Slack, just as a, you know, kind of shortcut. But there will be your Git analysis. So your week one, your week zero Git analysis already there. You can see and start familiarizing yourself what are essential elements, you know, that we look for sometimes. So that means, like, you know, the number, most of the analysis, and we'll discuss probably tomorrow as well on that. So your analysis of your week zero Git repository is there. And then as we build from week one, and when we compute your competency, the competency will be also be there, and other dashboards will be just as features will come in. Right now, there is the only thing, the 3 things that are gonna be active are the competencies, your competencies in radar form, like that means just in the 11th competencies that you would have, you would be able to see where you are, and the Git analysis of the week, as well as you can just explore, of course, week by week, and then the leaderboard, which is basically gonna be when it's released, you will see it there. So those will be the 10X system, and, you know, we'll write a bit more detail in email, just also repeating what I said, you know, your email is your first login and password. So with that, I think, is there any announcement from a non-technical side as well, Arun or anyone in the team? How many do we expect this week?
We should be 47.
No, in terms of like the non-technical assignment. So
we'll have 2 challenges this week, 2 careers challenges this week.
Okay. So yeah, so I think it's going to be, as I said, a lot more identical, other than just the number of submissions. It will be in the technical side will be just one data. So that would be a telecommunication. And the main focus this time will be a lot more being advanced in your Python way of dealing. And so you would see, I mean, the challenge document, when you see it, you'll be able to know, you know, to see the format is the same. There's a business understanding, and then the kind of the competencies and what skills you and knowledge and attitude you are more likely to add in your portfolio, as well as also the kind of, we make sure that the grading part or how we evaluate your work is much more detailed, so that you'll be able to know, you know, how, which elements we focus in the week. So every week we're gonna give you that, like how leaderboard is computed. So that should be, you know, your guide in terms of like, okay, what we want you, like where are, when there is a higher value in that, in one term, for example, then you'll be able to see that is our way of kind of design where we want to focus that time. So this time is a lot more, the EDA part is kind of has more values, as well as also your way of writing your report will be something, you know, it carries a significant amount. So every time, just as I'm saying, when you see it, you should really read the challenge document. Monday, you must be so understanding the challenge. And if you don't, you'll be struggling. So one of the advice that I would give is that the challenge document, just don't see it as just a way of like, okay, you know, it tells you what to do and then you go on. But you really have to understand, because we spend a lot of time in that, such that we communicate through the challenge document, through one truth. So whatever is not in the challenge document, of course, we should ask, we should improve it. Sometimes, you know, there are limitations, how much detail we can give, and it may not be clear. So as you did in week zero, definitely write and ask us to make it better, to make it understandable. But we will specify everything there so that at least the basic elements, like, you know, when is the submission, what type of submission is required, and how we are evaluating the work, and kind of also the tasks. Those are the elements that you should be very familiarizing, I would say, in the morning, if not at least just, you know, by 1 p.m. UTC, you definitely, on Monday, you should be able to be so familiar. And if not, just ask really rapidly and, you know, kind of make sure you understand what is asked. And without that, you would really risk, you might work a lot, but we might not be able to see it because, you know, there might be divergence. So I would say, make sure you spend a lot of time understanding the challenge, understanding the business context, to whom it is, you know, who's going to be my audience, like whom am I going to present at the end, whom am I going to write, you know, if it's asked, for example, a report, you know, what kind of report am I asked? So in week zero, what I observe a lot is that some people miss the point of to whom they are writing, right, the audience. And I think in a blog, you're writing mostly, like if you're publishing it in a medium, you know, you are writing it to the public, and a public, and then you have to decide which form of audience you want to address. Is it the person who already is familiar with Python, so you keep them whatever, or is it familiar, you know, somebody that is kind of much more, who's coming, who's a beginner? So it helps that kind of thinking. Or if it's a client, most of the time when we say reports, and if it's not a blog or if it's a slide, it's mostly the, you know, you are addressing the client. So in that way, just ensure that. We try to structure it this time, at least a little bit. Still, I'm sure there is a lot of gap we'll fill over time, but we try to give you at least, you have to have these sections, like each of the sections we give them, like if you have to talk about data, you have to talk about the methodology, you have to motivate it, and you have to also be able to describe the result and discuss the result. And also you have to describe a section about, you know, what you observed, right? So in a way, the conclusion part. So at least those elements need to be clearer, so that you get the full mark. So I think, yeah, that's the type of clarity that is needed. And as I say, the document makes most of these things clear. And community, of course, community is the cornerstone of our style and the Maintain Academy. So definitely keep up the good work. And we also look and also give a significant amount to community contribution. And also, of course, you know, career readiness is the key. It's like all of this is to prepare you for the job. And without, you know, career skill, we have seen again in the batches before, there were like really smart who writes amazing code, but they were unable to find jobs easily. And mostly because of their career skill or their understanding or misunderstanding of how important is communication, how important is presenting yourself. So this is really, I would say sometimes it's really sad from my side to see people are so smart, but they just fail to understand the importance of these career skills, like in terms of presenting yourself and, you know, how you, you know, what it means, what a client needs, you know, it's like, what are they, when they talk to you, how they evaluate you, the same as we evaluate you in weeks. And you have to know, you have to get the mind of like the client and the, you know, the employer, why are they hiring you? And they have a certain biases as well. And so you have to demystify that bias in some way. So, I mean, Arun and the team would really, of course, have prepared, and we have learned a lot over time, so that they would tell you there will be a lot of wisdom in all of this career. So I would say this, the community career and the technically being savvy is going to be the main iterations in weeks to, you know, from weeks to weeks. And so we know some of the, we really go into detail of your grading. So make sure also you, in your GITs, for example, once you start using, so I'm just now giving you the kind of tips from what we have observed in the past and what you should be prepared. So we, right now, even we have more detailed analysis, but even before that, we were looking at your commit history. Like in GITs, for example, when I evaluate, what I'm going is that I just open, if you have 30 commits, I go into your 30 commits and I look at how you propagated over time, right? It is not about, I think there were people we haven't accepted, even if they did so well, because they just jumped from one commit to another commit. Great, super. And it doesn't show, and it is very hard to see how that person was unable to do much and then just suddenly jumped like from one to another over time. It doesn't give me confidence. It's kind of, as we said, we are driven by evidence. If we can't see the evidence, sometimes we would be forced to at least observe you longer, or not at least credit as much as if you show us the evidence, right? So regular commits, and commits, of course, with a proper, like, for example, if you are about to fix some bug that you found, just saying like, you know, found bug and, you know, kind of like that, or your commit history would really help. And on top of that, you're also just always, I know how challenging it is to just like, whenever you want to commit, just prepare a certain form of like, okay, now you have to prepare a message. You know, what message you give it. But if you just determined how you're gonna, you know, the verb and the kind of the statement you wanna go to, so you could choose very keywords, like just saying like, you know, if it's bug, if it's feature, and if it is new commit, it's new commit, you know, new folder, something like that, it will help you and it will help us as well as we go. And it's important if you show a certain form of like you struggle, if it doesn't work, if you find out something, if you're restructuring, calling it that way will help. Of course, we will see the code and we will know what it is, but it will also help a lot more in that way. So your Git is basically your footsteps, you know, it's kind of in the technical sense, it's the footstep that helps us see how you're progressing over time. Okay. So, you know, use the Git functionalities as much, you know, branching, merging. A number of people, for example, in week zero weren't able, even people here were not able to merge. They were just always just keeping it separate, like from one branch to another branch. That shouldn't be the case. You are branching so that you can work on something and then you then merge it when you finish, right? And then you build on top of that. And if there is conflict, of course, resolving that conflict is what is the, you know, your role. So in a way, try to always just, you may work parallel in multiple branches, but as soon as you finish the branch, developing it, you know, is a good habit to merge it, so that the main, we shouldn't be able to see every time, you know, what in every branch, in principle, if I see that you merge it, this branch to that branch, then great, then I will look at the main only. And it will really help you that we don't miss your work. It also helps us to reduce the kind of amount we will spend. So those are the kind of another elements that will help in overall for your work readiness. It's not just only for us. It's really, that's how the industry does. You know, you take from a main, you fork some, you know, you branch something, you work on something, and you kind of push it back with pull request in any serious organization. So that's just the kind of flow. And you have to adapt that flow. You have to get used to it. Like at first, it might be foreign, but at, you know, just like anything, you'll get used to it. Okay. So definitely, Didier, I will come. So just if there are other additions, I would ask, and then I will open it for QA, just in terms of around this in alignment. So we need to be aligned. Therefore, I'll just open it up. But just before that, let me just see Arun. And team, what?
Sure. I mean, so. Yeah, so I prepared a brief presentation. just it's adding to what Yababel said and more taking maybe one step back. And so we have this intensive training, which is coming up, but what's the point? And so, yeah, I mean, do you want to, okay, I can present and then we'll do a longer.
Exactly, present and then, exactly.
Yeah, okay. Give me a second here. So first of all, welcome to everyone. We're glad you're here. We are now changing our mode from the selection process into we are now together and we want everyone who's here to finish and finish well. So introduction, presentation is not well formatted, nevertheless. So I want to just talk about what's the goal of the next 3 to 6 months, how we picked you, what's coming up in the coming 6 months, so both the intensive training and the supported job search phase, what our suggestions are to be successful, recapping the goal, and then who are the teams that you're going to work with on our side. So our goal is that you are ready for and that you secure a global level job as a machine learning engineer, a data engineer, or a Web3 engineer in about 6 months. So we say about 6 months because it's impossible to guarantee that anyone will get a job. But in our experience, it takes about 6 months if you follow the system. The three exit points are ML engineer, data engineer, or Web3 engineer. And we'll talk in a moment about when you have to make that decision. Our goal is that you have the necessary competencies that employers are looking for, and you can demonstrate those competencies in a form that employers expect. So if you are brilliant, as Yababel said, but you are not able to share that with employers and they can't understand how brilliant you are, it's not useful. So you have the competencies, you can demonstrate those competencies, you have the confidence in your abilities to get through an interview and to get a job, and you recognize that your first job is only one step along your career. So we don't just want you to get a job. Everyone can go get a job tomorrow driving an Uber or driving a taxi or being a security guard. We want you to get a first job, which is one step on a career. So selection was done over multiple stages and each stage was testing something different. So we went from 958 applicants to 48 people that are here. So through the application, including the essay and the biographical information, prerequisite quiz, thought chain, where alumni voted on you. We did a review of nationality and year of graduation as well. I didn't include that. The week zero was provided us with a lot of information, and then finally an interview. So everyone that's here has been through each of these 5+ stages. And we look for motivation or hunger. How aligned were you to our goals? Which means people who really want to get a job at the end of the training, work ethic, community contribution, and how much did you know? And prerequisite knowledge for us is really important because we only have a limited amount of time. Given a longer amount of time, we could take anyone. And that's something for the future. But for now, motivation or hunger, alignment to our goals, work ethic, community contribution, and prerequisite knowledge. And you'll be surprised or not surprised to know that every week from now on, we are only going to be looking for the same things. And the prerequisite knowledge drops away. Motivation, alignment, work ethic, community contribution. We'll talk about that in a moment. So what's coming up over the next 3 to 6 months? So weeks 1 to 4, we have 4 challenges, 1 per week, and those are mostly focused on ML engineering. Weeks 5 to 8, we're going to be developing our careers materials, CV, LinkedIn, GitHub, to start making them visible in a way that employers expect. And then we have additional challenges, about 4 more, and we start adding in data engineering and Web3 engineering content. Weeks 9 to 12, we will select one track, ML engineering, data engineering, or Web3 engineering, and our first draft careers materials will be ready to present to employers. So it should be at the point where you can start applying, and then additional content, again, ML engineering, data engineering, Web3 engineering. So overall, we expect to have about 6 weeks focusing on ML engineering, about 4 weeks focused on data engineering, and about 2 weeks focused on Web3 engineering. And sprinkled throughout that, we're going to have guest talks, we're going to have careers challenges, we're going to have community sessions, and we are going to be learning together. And I don't just mean that we will be training you, we will also be learning from you on how to improve the materials that we're putting out there and the support that we provide towards our overall goals. Everyone who's here is part of the 5th batch of training, and we continue to try and improve the support that we provide batch on batch. During the supported job search phase, which starts in July, runs from July to October, we're going to be asking you to rework relevant challenges so that you can walk through them with an employer on an interview. So for the majority of people, the 1 week is not really enough to do the entire challenge well. But once you pick your track, and people have asked during the interviews, do I need to pick one track? We recommend strongly yes. And you should be reworking those relevant challenges so you can step through them on an interview with people. Nobody will have, we have 12 different competencies and you'll be learning about that as we go. Nobody will be perfect in all of those. So let's identify areas of weakness and upskill yourself. So one typical area of weakness is SQL programming. So let's go and improve our SQL. And there's a number of ways that we can do that, but the support that we will provide is not only to tell you to go learn that, but to identify where are you weak compared to what employers are looking for. And then it's going to be this cycle of through applying for multiple hundreds of jobs, applying, learning, interviewing, learning until you get the job. There is no magic. And even if you are, it doesn't matter who you are and what level of experience, the interview and the job search process is, it's a very messy, noisy, not necessarily a straightforward process. Sometimes it goes very quickly, sometimes it's very difficult, but you need to be ready not to expect any magic. And we need to be ready from today that we start thinking of what is it that we need to do to get the job that we want to get. So we need to be moving very, very much in sync towards that one goal. And if anyone here expects that the job search training process will lead to a magic job with a job offer at the end of the process, please recognize that is not the case. Each of you will have to work hard to get a job, and we will be ready to support you. Yeah, sorry, I was just reading the comment. There is no magic. And then through the supported job search phase, there's regular stand-ups and an active community, and we'll be there with you. So a couple of points on how to be successful. So as you've seen to get this far, the majority of you are here just because you put in more work than your colleagues. So there are no shortcuts to putting in a lot of effort. And what we've seen over the years is that those people who are able to keep up that work ethic, not for 1 week, not for 1 month, but for 3 to 6 months, they have a system which works for them. They make sure that their internet works, that they have food, they can sleep well, they're not running around the city struggling, but they've taken the steps that they need to take to make sure that the infrastructure is in place. So putting in a lot of work is an important part of being successful. Being curious is an important part of being successful. So we'll expose you to a lot, but there's a lot more that you need to learn. So figure out what you're interested in learning more about and go deeper in that area. And so we really recommend that you don't maximize whatever metric we put in place, be it leaderboard, points, scores, badges. We'll have a number of things that'll drop, but maximize the learning that you have. Play the long game. Get curious about some of the things that we expose you to. Get curious about what a guest speaker talks about and go and learn that. And if you don't have time to learn it during the week that we expose you to that in the training, write it down and go back. But be curious. Don't just play the system. Community is really important. And why is it important? Because as you take up more and more complicated jobs, it's more and more likely that no one person can do all of that work by him or herself. You will have colleagues, you will have coworkers. The majority of you, I think, will be working remotely. And so you need to be able to work well with your colleagues. If you are the most brilliant programmer, but you cannot work well with other people, you are unlikely to be successful. Use this opportunity now to start practicing how to work with other people, including people from different countries, including people who are really difficult, including people who are completely different than you. This is your chance to practice. So you should practice helping others, teaching others and letting others teach you, extending your network. Somebody here said your network is your net worth. Very true. Build deep connections, especially outside of those that you know in real life. Many of you do know each other in real life. Get to know other people. So collaborate, build trust, talk with each other, including on stand-ups, and help us figure out how you will make a contribution to future batches of 10 Academy. You guys are all now part of the 10 Academy family. The ability to self-learn is super important, as we've seen over the past years. So when you get into work, many employers, and maybe you'll remember this, 9th of May, you will sit down at work at some point and your manager will be like, look, I want to get here and I have no idea how to go and get there. So go figure it out and let me know. And so that's a skill that you need to practice. Each of you is able to do that, but it's a good chance to start practicing that. And also understanding where are your gaps in knowledge. Understand what it is that you don't know and learn how to get there and figure that self-learning aspect, it's an important skill to learn. And the last point around how to be successful that I wanted to touch on is we expect you to be professional. This is not school, this is a training. So we have a bit of a tradition that we started last year. If anyone refers to anyone else as a student, then they need to tell a joke because we don't have any students here. We have trainees. This is a professional environment, and we expect you to behave in a professional way. So what does that mean? It means that we expect you to show up for a guest talk. We work with guest speakers so that they show up and they can impart some of their knowledge to you. But if anyone is too busy working on their code or they're commenting on their report to get a new aspect of knowledge, in my mind, that's unprofessional, because the guest speaker is volunteering his or her time to be there and you don't have the time to show up. We expect you to be professional. We expect you to do your own work. Copying will not get you further in the long run. And we want you to work with us to make this community and the overall community better than when you left it. And there are many other ways that we expect you to be professional, but let us take what we have here as a professional training opportunity. This is not school, and we expect that from you. And we will also expect that of ourselves. If we don't meet that standard of professionalism, I would encourage you to tell us. And so we'll come to the questions at the end. So just recapping, our goal is that you are ready for and you secure a global level job as ML engineer, data engineer, web3 engineer in about 6 months. So that takes us into October 2022. You have the competencies that employers are looking for. You can demonstrate them to employers, because if you're brilliant but sitting in a mountain and nobody can talk to you, it doesn't matter. You have the confidence and you recognize that your first job is one step in your career. And so my last thing that I wanted to touch on are, who are we and how do we organize ourselves? So you have all of the tutors that Yabuba alluded to. So we have a tutoring team of 5 plus Yabuba, and so they'll be working with you on the technical side of our work. We have the careers team, which is 3 plus me, and that's they'll be working with you on the careers challenges plus your job search. You have Everest and Mary, who are making their training operations, making sure that everything runs, scheduling, links, planning, group assignments, et cetera, et cetera. We have the technology team, which is Abdullahi. So if you have something which is not working, you need access, let him know. And then you have the 10X team, which you haven't met, but they're working, and they've been working, putting in a huge amount of work over the past couple of months to build a system. And so you will integrate with, you will interact with them in terms of them providing support, reporting and fixing bugs and ideas to make improvements to the system. Yeah, so that's all from my side. So I would really encourage us to get into this mode of let's make this a discussion as opposed to a presentation.
Yeah, great. So just before, is there anyone from Everest, any announcements so that we just get directly to discussion? Is there anything that is outstanding so that we finish that and we get into the discussion?
You can just start the discussion.
Okay, wonderful. Then it was Didier. Let's start.
Yeah, thank you so much, Ibabe and Arun, for the great presentation. Yeah, mine was a clarification about maybe how we are going to do our commits to GitHub. Do you expect us to like commit after every, maybe in terms of OOP, like after every function, or maybe work on the entire class and then commit after? Like, can you clarify on which basis we have to commit arrow you, like to grade us? Yeah, okay,
thank you. Yeah, so there isn't one fits all. And so the usual is definitely commit frequently. So when you feel something, you know, you are leaving your work, like, I don't know, to go for lunch, just commit it, right? With a certain, so there is a unit in your head of work, right? So sometimes that unit of work is very different. Sometimes if it's a big fix, it could just be like a one line fix and that's done, right? So even a one line improvement, it just, you commit that. And it could be just that a description, a readme that you want to add a link, you also commit that, right? And then sometimes you just actually develop a new folder where you're kind of actually writing the certain things, and you may need to just wait a little bit to actually make it, I don't know, somehow structure it, you know, import it until all the imports, whatever in that folder. And that might require ultimately when you submit, you may be submitting, I don't know, 5 files together like as one commit. So all of that, but it's just a unit of work and commit as frequent as possible. We don't care in that how, but better if you are also associating it with a better or the good message. So for example, bug fix of, you know, minor bug fix or major bug fix could be a certain indication, but also like, you know, a challenge, like your own challenge you're going through, like you thought you discovered something and then you didn't, you know. So that process will also help, because every element is a unit. So I hope that is clear. It's not particularly, there is like, I don't know, every function you have to do. No, there is no rule like that. It is much more of a unit of task and frequent as possible so that you don't lose your work, as well as also you see. If you go back and if you read your own week zero, you will see, oh, is that good or bad? I think you'll be able to see, like, did you actually record your history? Because just like a lab in a, you know, if you were a biologist or anyone working in a lab, you'd be recording your activities. And it's exactly like that. You are just recording your activity. So I hope that is clear. Yeah, does that yes, address? Yeah. Okay, great.
Yes, Biniam. Yes.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, good morning, everyone. Abdubal, thank you for those great tips. They were really helpful.
So you are a bit faint.
Okay. How about now?
Now much better.
Okay. Aaron, your presentation answered a lot of my questions, so thank you for that.
No, but I think you... Like, I think somehow your mic... So let's pass it, and then if you could just fix your mic. Because now there's a noise, a huge noise. That's not good.
Okay, how about now?
Now is better.
Okay, I'll keep it under my mouse. Okay. I just have one question. Will we have access to all the tasks in materials all at once, or are they released part by part on some periodic basis?
So the challenge is contains everything, all the tasks. So if you can mute it, I think there's a noise, Biniam. So the challenge is released, like all tasks, you know, you will be able to plan your work accordingly. So, but I'm not sure, Arun, maybe.
I think he means all 12 weeks. I think that's the question.
Oh, in that case, no. It's week by week.
So I could be wrong, but so, I think he meant all 12 weeks.
Yeah, Arun, that's right. That was my question, so thank you.
Okay.
Great. And so one of the reasons, just to add to that, is and that's part of the reason for our late policy, people need to focus on one thing, take a break. That Sunday break is also part of your work. So we don't want people exhausting themselves.
Yeah. Yeah, I think, you know, for all practical purposes, every week is just a complete project. There's no dependency per se. So in a way, there's no need from planning perspective, there's no need to know about what comes tomorrow, like, or what comes next week. Of course, we structure it in such a way that whatever the skill that you do today becomes part of, you know, we might give a task a lot more weight this week, but we would assume that you are familiar with that, and next week it has a less weight, so that, you know, you incorporate it. In any way, we will ask it, but it's like, it will build on, because we know that unless you repeat something you don't understand, especially new concepts, new way of working. So that is the case, but yeah, okay. Martin.
All right, thank you. Good morning.
Morning.
All right, I had a question I wanted to ask concerning the entire process. Is there going to be like a specialization in the course of the time, or it's just like tasks will be coming from different lines each and every time, and we'll have to be diverse?
Arun, do you want to?
Sure. Yeah. So our goal is that, as mentioned, everyone, all trainees will have to finish all 12 challenges, and the specialization will come afterwards. So there's two parts to it. One is we expect people to pick a specialization which is likely, which they're likely to match into the world of work. And so once they pick that specialization, we still want everyone to complete all the different challenges. But then we expect, or what we've seen is that people have to go back and rework those challenges in which they're interested. So if you decide that you want to be a data engineer, you must still complete all the different challenges. But it's likely that you will need to go back and rework and redo the data engineering challenges to get to the level where you can walk through that with an employer. So that's number one. The second is, if we look at our competency graph, there are certain skills that you'll probably need to improve on, or certain aspects of understanding. So for example, if you want to be a Web3 engineer, you need a certain number of skills, but you also need a certain understanding of how A, B, or C works. And so once you identify that weakness, to go back and improve on that. So maybe I can ask you a question, Martin. On what basis are you going to make that decision? Is it based on where you're most likely to get a job? Is it based on your interest, or is it based on a combination of the two?
A combination of the two.
Yeah. And so part of our job in the careers team, and actually the whole team, is to let you know what our employer is looking for. And we want to make that decision together, because there are certain, in our experience, there's often a gap between the understanding of what employers are looking for and people's quote unquote hopes and dreams. And so we have a time limited goal of getting everyone into work. We have skin in the game as well. That skin in the game is this pay it forward pay. We want 10 Academy to be sustainable. If you don't place into work, we will not be financially sustainable. We cannot do batch 6. So we have skin in the game. And so that's why we will work with you to satisfy this criteria.
Great. So you can also update your expectation. So if it's not, even if you don't have question, but you want to rephrase your expectation, so that is also possible. It's just, so how are you feeling? You can tell us. So let's start a few people, their readiness, their kind of expectation. Just I would give 3 chances. So I can also just call. Okay, Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr, you can unmute. Okay, maybe your mic is not working. Amal?
Hello. Yeah. So for me, basically, I'm eager to see myself in 12 weeks' time. I will be now. And I believe that I'll put a lot of hard work.
Great. Yeah, no, I think that's the key. Yeah, and any ideas on how you want to arrange yourselves or how you want to arrange yourself to allow you to keep up working, let's say 6 days a week, 10 hours a day for 12 weeks? Do you need to make any changes to your setup?
Not really, but I think I have planned my time well. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Great. Do you have any questions about what we've laid out in terms of the roadmap? Because it's 12 weeks, it may not be 12 weeks. There's an additional 3 months that we think may be required to get ready. Are you mentally ready for that job search interview process as well?
Yes, 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 I am.
Okay.
Thanks.
Great, Abu Bakr, do you have your mic working?
Hello, can you hear me now?
Yeah, we do.
Thank you very much, Arun, for sharing with us the presentation.
I'm not sure if it's audible. It's kind of. Can you be closer?
It's possible to hear, but difficult. Yeah. Maybe speak up, Abu Bakr. That's another approach. It's a very serious group. We'd expected more discussion, more chat, more questions.
So, Abu Bakr, go on.
Yeah, thank you very much. I'm just having a disconnection on my internet here. Anyways, I want to say thank you to Arun for the presentation. That was great. And of course, I know that this is going to be intensive, as you guys have already said. And it's going to be learning. And of course, we're going to improve our skills by the end of the program. So I saw you included machine learning 6 weeks, data engineer 4 weeks, and also web three engineer 2 weeks. So I want to ask, are we going to do them simultaneously, or is it going to be at the first 6 weeks, it's going to be machine learning, then the second 4 week going to be data engineer, and the last 2 weeks going to be web three engineer. I just want to ask, if is that how it's going to be, or we're going to do them simultaneously, each and every one of them?
Yeah, but that's better for you.
No, so it's not simultaneous. It's going to be interleaved. I think it's the first 4 weeks are much more machine learning, given that it requires a mix of everything. But then from that on, it's kind of a mix. Sometimes data engineering, sometimes. So it's a week based. So in 1 week, you're going to be doing focused on one area, because just in 1 week, it's not possible to introduce. But that being said, Web3 being slightly different topic, and a lot more people don't have the background, even in the first 4 weeks, we will have guest talks and some other talks and some other discussions, special sessions that would introduce the conceptual framework of Web3. So even if there isn't a project, we will be introducing, until you get to the actual Web3 project, we will get especially the blockchain concept and related concepts. Does that address?
Yeah, okay, thank you.
I just wanted to add one more point. I mean, let's look at it the other way. Let's say somebody was only interested in data engineering, for example. Our goal, as mentioned, was to get you ready for a global level job. And even it's not only the technical skills, it's also the approach, it's the deployment skills, it's the communication skills, it's a question of culture, it's a question of working with a community, it's a question of working with common tools. And this is part of the reason why everyone does everything, because we need to change our mindset from, I need to be a technical expert to get a job. It's, you need to have some technical skills along with knowledge, along with culture, along with practice, along with confidence, along with being able to demonstrate that, and having a network, and be ready to have that, what is the right word, the endurance to get there. So I think many of you, if we are honest, you could have gone and learned almost everything that we're providing online. Why doesn't that work? Because it's the way that it's organized. I think that's why everyone has to do everything before we have the confidence in saying, we think that this person is job ready. And it's not just confidence based on how nice you smile, it's based on how well you perform, and also our understanding of what employers are looking for. So I think we have to go switch our mindset. There, as Yevabel said at the start, there are plenty of brilliant people who don't have the right attitude, and that's what's holding them back from getting into work. And that's what's, if nothing else, we've asked a number of our alumni, especially batch 3 and 4, what's the most important thing that you learned from us? Nobody said technical skills. Everyone said it's the approach to solving problems and the approach to work.
Thank you very much.
Fade.
Yeah, thank you, Arun and Yabiba, for the introduction. And congratulations to my colleagues who are here, that we made it this far. My question is, during week zero, the work was a bit too much. And if we are honest, it was tough to make all things work perfectly, because I have
I have this side of me which is quite perfectionist, so I have to feel really good about my work before I submit, and that was mostly impossible with those week zero challenges. And at some point you would tell us that they don't have to be perfect, that we don't have to hand in perfect work. You just want to see our approaches and how we approach the question. I was wondering if that's still the case with week one challenges and all the work we'd be doing, or since the workload quite reduced, if it changed.
No, I think the workload, it's slightly different in a way that you don't submit every day. There are only two submissions. That means one interim submission on Wednesday and another one on Saturday. And that basically means you're gonna spend more time working. But in terms of the actual workload, again, that's what we require, 10 hours a day and 6 days a week. Mostly because if you are familiar to a certain concept, maybe it might get easier, but it's gonna be a new concept. And some of the, you know, most of the challenges I would say are normally done in 3 months or a term project. Even then it will be like really intense. So I don't think the workload goes down, but you get used to it. That's what I think over time, you start getting used to the rhythm. And I think most people get used to the rhythm, I don't know, by the third or fourth week. It's no more a surprise that it's all about, you know, you go on and then you will have another chance to improve it further later, because the same concept might come. For example, we will focus, because we are also engineers, we really focus on the engineering element, right? So the engineering element means even how you commit, how you, you know, what kind of tools you use, versioning, and kind of all of that, and structuring, planning. So it's really a number of it is just gonna be adding more and more, introducing you to tools, introducing you to concepts. So I think the workload is not, I mean, it will be better, but it's not, don't expect it to be, I mean, again, just like the workload on week zero for some people was quite overwhelming, for some people was okay. So it's gonna be probably the same here, but the submission not being every day, of course, will help. That means you will structure and you can plan and strategize to meet the requirement.
Thank you.
I just want to offer an alternative perspective, Faith. One of the things that you need to get used to is it's not only about us, but when you get ready for the world of work, when you get a job, your employer will always expect more from you than you can reasonably manage. And so I think you have a well-framed it a good way. You'll get used to it, but you'll also get smarter about prioritizing. And no matter what job you have, your manager will be super happy if you find somebody who will work until he or she doesn't sleep. But you'll very quickly realize that that's not sustainable. So I think our experience is it feels a lot easier, even if you end up being as productive.
Thank you very much.
And one last point there, we do not want to burn anyone. It's not to our advantage. That's why we have community events, we have people there. If people burn out, it's not to our advantage. So we'll make sure, we'll do our best that people don't.
Yeah, I think just rephrasing what just Aaron said, we're not making you work hard because we, you know, that is a way to do. It's because in 3 months to prepare you for a job and in a global ready job, then it is required. Like it's basically just, we cannot do it without. So it is definitely have to work hard. You have to learn the mindset. And, you know, like some people who looked at the previous batch, who looked at the other side, that means like our side, they said, oh, I didn't know that you were also working that hard. But actually we do work as hard as you do. So in some way, it is not just we give you work and then you do it. I think there is prepare, you know, we want to really learn that every task that we give you has a certain component to make you ready for a job. And there is no other metric for us other than just to prepare you such that you get quickly into job, because that's our interest, right? So that's the aspect. So in a way that you know what just Aaron said, but in a different version. Okay, Samuel.
Can I add one more thing just to add to that? We're preparing you for, in our experience, people who do really well in our training program get to the world of work, and they are in the top X percent of work ethic at wherever they work, be it in the US or in Europe. You get used to this rhythm where you are outperforming your American or your European colleagues, and you should be able to do that in a sustainable way.
Samuel.
Okay, hello everyone, can you hear me?
Yes, we do.
Okay, first of all, thank you both of you, nice clarification. And my question is the weak assessment going to be more direct approach to asking, or is like more of a broad, and I mean sense like do this, or like here's some data and do something out of it? What's your approach? And the second one would, I'm sure you'll all be giving us a resource. Is the resource more direct or more of a broad?
That's I think it's going to be as you'd see. It's just also what was in the week zero. It's going to be, there will be a task. The task is specified in a certain way, but I don't think it is like specifying. It's just specify what the need, where you should land, or what the kind of the expectation, what you should get, or what you should deliver, or what needs to be done. But how you do it, there is a huge degree of freedom there, and that's the quality. So, but we specify, it's kind of guiding. We lead you, because it's a 1 week, we can't do both the thinking and the kind of the planning, whatever. So we basically translate. So another way to put it is that there is a business need, and the business needs to be translated to whichever way, a machine learning task or a data engineering task or a Web3 task. We translate that, and then we give you, okay, to achieve that business need, you will need to do X, Y, Z. And then we ask you to do that and to submit, for task X, Y, Z, just submit this. So in that way, that's clearer. But the amount of work you do, the quality differences you would see is very large, because some people just try to achieve. But even if you achieve that, what we ask you, we think it is sufficient. That's a bare minimum, that's sufficient. But of course, most of the time, it's you will do whatever is in your capacity. So it's kind of, I would say, it's not broad, that it's not like put you in the, without any constraint, but also it invites for, if you have skills, it will invite you to explore your skills further. So it's not like completely like, okay, deliver this and only this. It doesn't say like that, but it specifies the minimum requirement.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So just for sake of time, we just give Jeremy, and then we will close there. Jeremy.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
I think I heard Aaron saying 6 days a week. So does it mean working on Saturday is also required?
I think the submission is on the end of Saturday. So that basically means, but we had certain situations in the past as well where some people couldn't do on Saturday, but maybe Aaron, do you want to elucidate on that?
So it's a question of how fast you want to go. So I think in our experience, the people who really finished, did the most work, they were working 6 days a week. Is it required to work on Saturdays? No, we have, again, we're trying to make it like the world of work. You have a set of tasks to deliver, you have a deadline, there are quality expectations. How you organize your time is up to you. Now, we've had people in the past for different reasons who didn't want to work on specific days. You're free to organize your time within that, but there's a certain, we have an expectation of how much work it will take the average person to get it done. And the majority of people in our experience work 6 days a week, and then they take Sundays off. But you are free, everyone is free to organize their time as they need to organize it. But I think one needs to be ready to put in about 60 hours a week.
But is it possible to finish the week challenge on Friday?
Yeah.
Okay, thank
you. Okay. Great. I think that would be the end for today's stand-up, but we'll continue tomorrow on basically also focusing on the kind of tasks, and you would receive the challenge document now. And also we invite you to join the 10x system, just so that you'll be able to see your at least gate analysis from week zero, and then all the other ones will be continued as well. Just your weekly analysis of the GitHub, the leaderboard, will be also in that login system. So it will be just your personal page where we will publish leaderboards and other information. Okay, so from my side, it is over, but if there are any from the team, any announcement, last minute announcement, just open it, otherwise we can close it here.
Yeah, the challenge document has just been shared. I'm looking forward to the next period of time with you. Mary's mentioning the next announcement, next session starts in 2 minutes. Let's have a good period of time together. Let's keep it as professional and as productive as possible, but let's not forget to get to know each other and enjoy ourselves along the way.
Great, awesome.
Thanks everyone.
Bye.
Bye.